went to the School of the Americas since kindergarten. We didn't really do birthday parties.
But you celebrated Christmas?
I don't have to explain myself.
Ultor's behind this, I know it.
Ultor and the Saints haven't been enemies in years. You really think he's responsible?
You don't know him like I do. The boss put him through a window for a reason.
The reason was the boss was kind of fucking crazy back then.
That's a fair point.
You know how much easier this would be if we just found a car?
You know how much easier this would be if you just gave me a second?
Seriously, want to hear me this fucking early in the morning? God damn, motherfuckers.
Ah. Alright. Now, how are we gonna find the Ultor building?
Biggest building down here. Giant Ultor sign on it. I don't think this is a problem.
I'll buy that.
It is 6:10 a.m., bro. 10 a.m. What the fuck? My kids are also sleeping. Trying to find out where I gotta go here. What's everyone up to? How's everyone's morning?
Keep it coming.
I was unsure if I wanted to stream this early, anything like that. I was a little bored. Titty! What's up, brother? Back up, you piece of shit. There we go. How's my family today?
Look at us.
What up?
Kinsey Kensington and Johnny Gat driving together on a birthday adventure.
Are you always this excited?
Generally, I'm a misanthrope.
I get it.
Let's just pray that Mike doesn't die here. Who's all played this game before? Anyone? Whoa, fucker. The fuck is wrong with you?
This is
not a fucking drive, asshole.
Not as bad as I
thought. Oh, shit.
Kind of reminds me of Steelport.
Oh, fuck. I'm gonna start reading no comments in a second. Gotta try not to die here.
Anyone else want to turn?
So, what's the plan?
Whoa.
I'm gonna shoot him in the face unless he gives us the boss back.
What if Dean doesn't have the boss?
I'll probably still shoot him in the face.
I thought it would be a nice little, switch up in Black Ops anyway, so everyone can see that a little bit better. PlayStation for Christmas. Nothing wrong with that, fam. I am wonderful, Titty.
Welcome to hell.
Shouldn't you have a receptionist?
No, reload. I'm not doing flip coin today. I'm not turning on my computer yet. I'm just chilling out.
Let's talk in my office.
Hey, wifey, how are you, darling?
Enterprising Vogel, who wasted no time.
All right, you got me out in the sticks. Now what?
Would it kill you to show a little excitement? You're about to experience angelic flight, for Christ's sake.
Dane.
Someone needs a nap.
Just collect some soul clusters and power up the halo. You'll be flying around in no time.
I'm gonna be flying. I'm gonna be flying. Whenever Satan's Row game, you start flying.
Just enough clusters to power up your halo. Start slow, try to jump over to that next island. Also, the longer you charge your wings before jumping, the further you'll go.
Holy shit.
Hey, you didn't fuck it up. Good job. Now get up that cliff. Don't worry, if something looks too high, just keep on jumping off the wall. Now it's time to fly. You heard of crawling before walking? Well, in this case, you need to jump before you can fly. Launch yourself in the air with a jump, and then hold your wings out to glide to that next island. You'll have to dive to reach the next island. Do that by pointing your head down. Don't worry, the rest of your body will follow.
I'm gonna die.
Put a shiny flap orb out in front of you. Collect the orb, and your wings will flap to gain speed. All right, now try flapping those wings on your own. Do a flap on your way to the next island. Opposite of diving is climbing. Climbing will slow you down and eventually cause you to stall.
I am wonderful, Mummily.
Stalling
I am
sucks.
Wonderful.
You can flap while gliding and gain additional speed. So
I
the faster you're going, the higher you can fly.
Too early.
Now try to reach the island up there.
But I didn't know what else to do, so I decided to play a game and, you know, the lovely stuff.
All right, time to take the training wheels off for the final lesson. Flying takes stamina. If you run out in midair, you are going to drop like a rock. A stupid, stupid, stamina-less rock. Last island is right under those lava falls. Notice how your stamina drains the longer you glide.
God, this feels good.
Holy
Let's get you
shit.
Back to the old Tor building. I want to run through all the stuff you can do to hurt Satan.
Sure.
Yeah, but I just didn't know what to stream, Mummily. I don't know. I've been bored with certain games.
Here's the deal. If you want some FaceTime,
I
want to
stream something
Satan,
people will watch,
attention.
You know what I mean?
Now, Satan hates being challenged, so anything you do to undermine his control is good. Fraud, mayhem, shooting demons in the face, anything. You can keep track of Satan's wrath with this handy meter. Get it high enough, and you'll be having drinks with Big Red in no time. I've compiled a list of shit to do, so take a look and do whatever sounds fun. Oh, one more thing. We have some potential allies down here. Trust me, you want to impress them.
It was a really scary game. I was gonna play this early, but you know. You never know if people are gonna actually watch. Alright. all done. All these lovely little challenges to do.
See how this thing handles. Anyone got a mop?
Lights up. William Shakespeare, humanity's greatest playwright, and hell's most diabolical purveyor of entertainment, looks on as a brave mortal on an Orphean quest enters. The bard's interest is piqued, and he looks to test his visitor's mettle. The masked tragedies were used to enemies cowering as they approached. But soon they realized that they faced a foe with courage and nobility. Traits uncommon in the fires of perdition. Exciting incident resolved. The time had come for rising action.
How the heck am I supposed to do this? No way I'm doing this. No way. Get out of here with that.
The battle raged on below, and as bullets and blood flew, the bard arched a curious eyebrow. Could this mortal be the exact thing that Shakespeare needed? We'll be right back.
Nice. What's up, Logic? What's up, bro? This is called Satan's Road. Yeah, out of hell.
Act 3!
Well, the hardest difficulty, apparently. I have to never play this shit. Apparently, I'm gonna die anyway. Oh, what the hell?
Much better
things. Oh. There we go, let's see what I can do here.
The conflict resolved. Shakespeare eagerly awaited meeting the champion that dispatched so many of his men. Undoubtedly, they were here for the Bard's End. And while happy endings were not a thing found in hell, Shakespeare always had a soft spot for comedy.
Enzo, what's up, buddy? Thanks for popping by, bud.
In the land of the living,
much love.
William Shakespeare is regarded as one of the most prolific playwrights of all time. However, to the denizens of hell, the bard is seen.
I don't drink iced tea, Mama Lee. No way in hell.
After selling his soul for fame and adoration, Shakespeare served in hell as Satan's spy master general. In doing his duty, Shakespeare would punish the souls he was investigating by forcing them to perform in grotesque passion plays for
what up, Logic?
Music.
You don't want to send me a fucking invite to a game? What the fuck? Fuck you two.
Shakespeare found himself living a double life.
How
was
work,
he
bro?
He projected an image of cruelty. His heart was as soft as Jezebel's. In secret, he would tutor her on the classics and act out the works of his mortal days. When Satan found out, he cast Shakespeare out of the palace, believing that the poet would be tormented by the populace of hell, far out of Jezebel's sight. But Satan had not counted on the bard's cunning. Embracing his persona of master torturer, Shakespeare and his followers, took root in the entertainment district, biding their time for revenge.
Bet you was long, bro. Everyone always thinks your type of work is easy, but it ain't.
The deus ex machina,
a lot of pain in the ass to go with it.
With the
yeah, sure, we get our ups and downs, but it's still pain in the ass. Alright, stop. Okay, cool. Yeah, you're right, I don't have IW, bro. If I did, you know I'd definitely play anyways. Let's see. Do we do a tutorial or do we just walk away from it? What do you think? Except you guys. Did you kill this fool, dude?
The bar gives exposition, which reveals that the president has been trapped inside some sort of soul crystal inside Satan's palace. The only way for our protagonists to save them is to draw Satan out by continuing their actions in hell. Lights up! The mortal stands in the training grounds, eager to try out his new force stomp power on the group of demons in front of them.
To battle!
Damn, motherfucker.
In which our protagonist is Act 2. In which our protagonist is greeted by foul imps. In which our protagonist learns that Force Stomp even works on flying enemies, enabling them to remove a Dark Inciter's shield before shooting them to death. With the day is won, and the curtain closes on our noble hero.
Hi, Faye. How are you, darling?
Do this all day.
We no one wanted to be up early and play with me. So I got stuck playing this shit. Just kidding. I didn't know what else to play. How's Faye today?
A Damned Souls Orientation Guide, Chapter 1. The Dead. Welcome to Hell, O ye of questionable morality. Who you were on Earth no longer matters. When you arrive here, everyone from the mightiest crime lord to the elderly gentleman who takes pens from banks begin the same way, as wretched ghouls wandering the streets. As a shadow of a man, you are stripped of your sin and condemned to a meaningless existence. Eternal playthings for a demonic host who is all too eager to fly.
Oh,
its
damn. You
wanna play too?
Ow. Fuck, that ain't even hard. God dang. Rotary.
Find a way to control lightning.
Ooh. Oh shit. Jumping. That map was so hard to read. That or I'm just fucking blind.
I hope there's not something ridiculous like 100 of these to find.
Apparently I fucking can't drive, guys. I blame it on Kitty. Party if you want, bud. We can talk. It don't mean nothing to me.
Got it.
Yeah, I said I blame shit on you, Ryan. Of course I did. Something to do. Just because I love you, bud.
abandoned ship! We've been boarded!
Hey, look, it's my kids in the morning.
Get these damn things off my ship!
Yeah.
Fantastic work. Yes, thank you. I am the scourge of the seven.
Always blame Rob. But be careful, he might join here and ship you some shit. Oops. Oh.
I got a bit of treasure in that chest over there. The weapon you find inside may help with our little imp problem.
Right here? We're gonna do it with a hammer. Oh, look at that thing. God dang
it. Shit. This reminds me of that one time I killed a lot of people. Why, you little bastard?
To serve as my crew. I forgot what a handful they could be. Once aboard, they wouldn't listen to their captain. They ran amok in the bowels of the ship.
Pirate voice.
What pirate voice would that be?
Wow.
No one else has to be robbed, that's funny. Unless it's lasers, right?
Zinyak's destruction of Earth had a profound impact on the afterlife. To heaven, it was a logistical nightmare. Saint Peter's meticulous nature drove purgatory wait times to unbearable levels. Meanwhile, in hell, where souls in pain were used as currency, it created a new era of prosperity for the wickedly enterprising. This economic boom resulted.
Hey, I didn't get to watch the rest of that live stream last night. Did you guys do it or what? Get that world record? That sailed the seven seas. Long had I ended up passing out super early.
Side, robbing tax collectors on a semi-regular basis.
Early enough.
But the promise of an immeasurable fortune drove him to be even bolder. An arrangement was reached. Blackbeard would provide information on strategic targets in exchange for a share of the profit. Johnny, who was interested in murder, not money, happily agreed.
I grant ye the ability to summon my crew whenever they're needed.
God hammer.
All right, matey. It's time for your lesson.
Well, you let me know whenever you want to play with. I'm always game, bro. Always game to play with you, bro. For sure.
Why don't you start off by summoning an imp to take out those enemies? There you go, matey. Now take down the other. Fighters are vicious. Now let's practice your aim. Take down the demons on the islands.
No, I'm dead. I killed myself. did. I didn't get to ask you how your trip was there, Wave. How did that go?
Few things are as rewarding as pressing someone into service, am I right? Now get going! There's a whole wide world waiting to be plundered.
You fucking up.
You should have expected this. You're in hell. Who's next?
Fucking driving in real life is a lot better than the video game. Yeah. Oh, he killed everyone in the goddamn mile. Goddamn, motherfuckers. Watch out, I'm driving here.
These things can do.
You gonna make it? Into a prison, apparently. What the
goes beep, 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 beep.
Whoa, buddy.
What, if they wanted to torture you, why'd they use the short?
No, please.
The short version?
Oh yeah! The wipers on the bus go swish, swish, swish.
The
homo on the bus goes heh, heh, heh. Come on.
80 of them.
Come on, die. Whoa, get the fuck out of here, that. Yeah, I died. What the hell? Reload. I'm not putting a point in right now. I was like loading up my computer. Sorry, bro.
Let us return to my castle, so we may plot our next steps in proper surrounds.
What if I just want to shoot you in the head? What cocksucker are you?
Johnny led Vlad back to his castle, which since his castle became a haven for frat parties.
Sounds like a porn castle to me.
But the systematic impaling of trespassers would have to wait. Vlad was a man of his word, and was eager to provide intel that could aid in hobbling Satan's armies.
Bestow upon you the Stygian cold fire.
Oh, nothing. Yeah, we did. Sure.
I brought you to this inferno to teach you about the power I have granted you. Coldfire is an aura, which means you must activate the power and get close to an enemy before they will feel the cold embrace of the Stygian flames. Try it against these demons. Well done.
I attack now. How are you?
Now here comes a dark inciter. Use your aura, then get close to him to take down his shields. From there, you've done it. Doesn't it feel good to watch an enemy burn?
Everyone's stopping by this morning. Much love, everyone. Jesus. Yeah, wave somewhere in there, Techno. Somewhere. She is. She is. She is indeed.
Off the bike.
Yeah, off the bike. What the heck is going on with this bike? Holy crap. I'm doing wonderful, bored, I didn't know what else to do, so I decided to play a game. I'm really kind of bored with this one too, it makes no sense. I'm so lost with it, it's unreal. But you don't buy games, they'll try them first.
Wrong face, bro.
Homeboy's gonna kill me. Oh, that's shit. Ragers. How are you today, Techno? Oh, there's a police. That's why. I guess there's a police now. Get the heck out of my way. No way.
Bullsh.
Motherfucker. They hopped on my ass like I was selling crack or something. Oh, you played this game before, Techno? Like, I played the old version, I guess you can say, of, like, you know, Saint Gro shit, but Saint Gro, get out of hell. Played some of it, but, fucked up. Apparently I can fly. Some guy, whoever made this game, was on acid. Okay.
Hey, looks like you kicked the dust off one of those ancient.
What's up, Adam? What's up, bro?
You find the right power to activate one of these things, and let's be honest, you have four to choose from. It's not rocket science. You'll be imbued with the new arcane element for that power. Sounds too good to be true? Well, it kind of is. Once you steal the power from the altar, a bunch of guardians will appear and try to kill you. But if you use your new power to clear them out, it's yours to keep.
Okay. I gotta use my new power and kill him.
In which our heroes are didactically informed that the vacuum stomp draws enemies towards you.
Give me a second, guys. I will reach out. Yes. Techno Thrive. If you're new, yeah. Sub button, like button. Oh crap. There we go. Well, congratulations, Adam. Congratulations, bro. It's a really good experience. It's a fun experience, I guess you can say. Finding out for the first time. Congratulations.
Run.
I'm dead. Oh, gee, my boy. What up? Just rocking me, eh? Stoking. Rocking. Stalking. Everyone's up in the house this morning. God dang. Get the heck out of here. What up? Yeah, no. Solid, all the ninjas are in here. For sure.
We're standing in a parking garage.
I don't like it either, but Centerpool isn't giving us many options.
I can't believe they tried to force us out.
I can't believe you forgot the mimosas.
I think we have bigger problems.
I don't think you realize how much I love mimosas.
I can't help but notice that people are trying to kill you.
Yeah, they're really big on that here.
What did you do?
It's not really a good time. We can wait until we're done shooting people.
Well, I'm great at multitasking.
Remember, he offered you a deal on that airplane, and
you responded by killing everyone?
Yeah.
It's like that, but worse.
God damn. I do not want to die.
Hey, Viola. Thought you should know that Kinsey misses you.
Really? That's so sweet. Who's Kinsey? You remember Kinsey. She was that hacker that Matt Miller hated. Isn't she crazy? You know, she really grows on you.
Oh my god, I'm gonna use that. Whoa, a grenade. There's fucking shooting frogs. What the hell?
Let's get you two back to Dane.
Hooray.
After being reunited in hell, Kiki and Viola wasted no time in doing what they do best. Facilitate the running of businesses. However, the De Winter sisters' success did not sit well with other would-be power players in hell. The sisters' operations all came under attack at once, forcing them on the run. Soon, the twins found themselves on the receiving end of an offer they couldn't refuse. After all, it was better to own one-fifth of something than to be dead.
Alright, guys, I'm gonna take a little bit of a bathroom break for a second here.
You helped us. Now let us help you. Here's a little something made popular by another group of sisters, the Gorgons.
I won't be too long. Techno, I'm sure you can handle chat for me. You know, since you guys love me. UNOG. Alright. I'm back, I guess. Turn you with a stone, apparently. Some sort of an upgrade? Great.
Satan never decided to step up. All right, Dane's letting us use his old tour training room to test out your stone blast power. So go ahead and blast these demons to turn them to stone. After they're petrified, you can use your pistol to shatter them.
You will feel pain for eternity.
You want to play too?
Nice. Stone blast is especially useful on flying demons like this one. All right, now let's see you drop a few more.
Yeah.
Hey, oops. We're trying to teach you how to use stone blasts here. So use the power, then... Got it?
Where are you going, buddy?
A blast will also take down the shield of a Dark Insider, leaving it vulnerable to gunfire. Take this Dark Insider out. I think you've got the gist of it. All right, let's go.
Best of luck to you boys for that Easter egg. Best of luck. Dude, what do I do next? Okay. That's it? Well, that's a kind of a shitty game. Now I just gotta kill people with the items that they create. That's it. This game's done. What kind of bullshit was that?
What the fuck?
I'm dead. Well, that was kind of a fucked up game to play. Beat it in under an hour. What kind of stupid shit is that? Whoever bought this game, I feel sorry for you. Techno, am I missing something? Try to go in there?
No. Leave the door closed.
Yeah, good. But how do you know?
Leave the door closed and I heard Willow crying. Willow opened the door.
Willow did. No, she didn't. She would have came down here.
She actually opened the door.
She didn't?
Just a little bit. And then
she would have came down here. Right? Yes. All right, well, what's next? Okay. Hey Techno, are you still on here?
But we should never forget the classic. Rampant fucking murder. Pride is a sin the Devil's Army has in spades, so if you want to pick a fight, you can bet your ass they're coming in droves.
Okay, what's going on here? Alright. I got a little croaker apparently.
got a model.
I didn't do it. I promise.
Who builds these fucking things?
I don't know how I died, but I died. Good job, Mike. You died. I died. I just died. What?
How did you even die?
I don't know. I just died, apparently. Like, no actual story missions to this game, apparently.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Apparently, there was no story missions. What kind of bullshit is that? Got to find a new game to play, apparently. Yeah. But whatever. Nothing but running around doing collectibles. It's bullshit.
Blackbeard kind of sucks at hiding these things.
What the heck does that mean?
No, like, Blackbeard.
I got word from Blackbeard that every island has a treasure chest hidden on it. What's in the chest? I don't know. I'm not a fucking pirate. What I do know is that if you want to get that thing open, you have to find three corresponding glyphs. Look on the bright side. Nothing's trying to kill you.
Okay. Nice to know.
You've just entered one of four soul extraction facilities. This is where souls enter hell to have their sins removed and then thrown to the streets to wander for eternity. Now make no mistake, this isn't Satan being magnanimous. Sins are the currency in hell. That means these places are the cornerstone of his income. There's three sections of the facility, and to fully take it over, you need to capture all three. But be careful. Satan's goons are going to be looking to reclaim any section you're not guarding. We pull this off, you'll hurt Satan and Ultor makes money. It's win-win.
Okie dokie. I don't know what the frig that means. Go away.
Thank you.
scared of you?
Think we got it. Boom. Damn, look at that motherfucker. Out when you're on fire. Whoa. Apparently I'm riding in a car. My God. Alright. I guess I shall end this one anyways, because this one seems like it's going nowhere for me. Shitty ass game. Apparently he dances like a moron, too. Well, peace out. Catch you guys in the next one.